In this video, we're going to compare the Deepcool AK400 to the Deepcool AS500 Plus using this test bench right here. The information in this video can also be found on my website at pcanalytics.com, and the product links can be found in the description below. With that in mind, let's start by looking at some qualitative metrics. Both coolers show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both coolers will not have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, the AK400 uses a single fan, while the AS500 Plus uses two fans, and it is possible to add a second fan on the AK400. In regards to installation, both coolers are relatively easy to install. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds, and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the AK400 cooler in red to the AS500 Plus cooler in blue, the AS500 Plus cooler has slightly better cooling across the board. Given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see the AS500 Plus cooler has materially better cooling performance at lower RPMs. However, this benefit diminishes as the fans increase to 100% fan speed. Additionally, when considering sound, the AS500 Plus is noticeably louder at higher RPMs, with the temperature benefit being minimal. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that the AS500 Plus retains slightly better cooling performance over the AK400. For the second set of comparisons, you will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis, while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing coolers by normalized noise levels, we can see that both coolers perform similarly at idle CPU levels. As we increase the watts to 105, we can see the AS500 Plus begin to outperform across comparable noise levels. And as we increase the watts to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, the AS500 Plus cooler has slightly better cooling performance for a given noise level, making it the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.